Hey, what's happening guys, it's your host Amok, back with another interesting video. And today, I'm gonna be comparing the camera performance of the Zenfone 4 Selfie Pro with those of the Xiaomi Mi A1. Now, I know there is no direct comparison between these two devices, but while testing out the camera of Zenfone 4 Selfie Pro, I found some very interesting results, hence I thought to make a video about them. The Zenfone 4 Selfie Pro is the higher-end version of the Asus Zenfone Selfie lineup, but the Mi A1 is a mid-range smartphone from Xiaomi. Now keep in mind that there is a price difference of almost Rs 10,000 between these two devices. The Mi A1 has a dual camera on the rear side, whereas the Asus has a dual camera on the front side. So it will be very interesting to see how these phones compete with each other with regards to camera. Let us quickly get the specification out of the way. Mi A1 comes in dual 12 megapixel cameras with face detect autofocus and dual tone flash. One of the camera has a regular 26mm wide lens with f2.2 aperture, and the other one has a 50mm telephoto lens with an aperture of f2.6. The Zenfone 4 Selfie Pro has only one camera at the back, which is a 16 megapixel shooter with 26mm wide lens with dual LED flash and electronic image stabilization. At front, Mi A1 has a 5 megapixel camera with f2.0 aperture, whereas Zenfone has two front cameras with 12 and 5 megapixel respectively. Here, first camera has a 25mm normal lens with f1.8 aperture, and the second one has a 12mm wide angle lens with LED flash including. The functions of the cameras on these two devices are very similar. On the A1, you have ability to zoom 2x optically with no loss of image quality, whereas with Zenfone, you can pinch to zoom, but it's digital zoom here. You also have portrait mode on both these devices, but the A1 uses the second lens for portrait mode, whereas the Zenfone does the same with the help of software. But again, you get almost similar set of modes with both these devices. Now that we know functions of both the cameras, let us take a look at some of the sample photos and videos that I have taken with these smartphones. As you can see, both the cameras does good job in outdoor situation. But if you look closer, images from Zenfone looks a bit pale to my liking. Also in this picture, A1's photo is a bit sharper compared to Zenfone. Also the A1 handles the exposure more accurately compared to Zenfone in my opinion. Now thanks to the secondary camera, you can take 2x shots with no loss of image quality with the Mi A1. Whereas you get normal pinch to zoom option with Zenfone, which is a digital zoom here. That's why images from A1 are more sharper compared to Zenfone in this scenario. Now when we turn the HDR mode on, images from both the devices came out to be good, but Zenfone's HDR gives more natural images by preserving the highlight. Now when it comes to focusing speed in video, Zenfone is a bit faster compared to Mi A1. Thanks to the dual pixel autofocusing technique, Zenfone is very fast while focusing on object. Now moving on to macro shots, here I would give my vote to Mi A1. Since the color accuracy is a lot better with the same. But in this picture, the background blur is more visible with the Zenfone image. But when we move to portrait shots, here the game completely changes. As you can see, A1 takes beautiful portrait shots in outdoor with background to be blurred out completely. But with the Zenfone, it is completely opposite scenario. Zenfone simply can't take portrait shot if the subject is not a human. As you can see, if the subject is a human, then it takes portrait shot with the blurred background, but again, I would prefer the portrait mode of Mi A1 over Zenfone. Now when we move to low light pictures, here I feel Mi A1 is doing slightly better job compared to Zenfone, but the noise level sometimes increases with A1, which can be annoying in some cases. But overall, I would prefer Mi A1 over Zenfone with regards to low light shots. Now when we talk about selfies, I don't think I have to tell you who's the winner here. Because as you can see, Mi A1 simply can't compete with the quality of photos which Zenfone takes from its front-facing camera. Like its name suggests, the front camera is the highlight of this device. You can even take beautiful portrait shots like this with its front camera, and they look fabulous in my opinion. Again, thanks to the secondary wide-angle lens, you can take 120 degree of wide-angle shots like this with the Zenfone. Now when we move to lower light selfies, here also Zenfone's camera simply kills the Mi A1. Sometimes I can't even recognize my face from the images of Mi A1, whereas with the Zenfone, it's a lot better. Also, you have front-facing flash in Zenfone, which can be pretty handy in some cases, which the Mi A1 lacks. Also, the video performance of the Zenfone is a lot better compared to Mi A1 with regards to both stability and color accuracy. Thanks to the electronic image stabilization, footage from the Zenfone is a lot stable, which in case of Mi A1 is a very shaky. So if I have to conclude the video here, I would say if rear camera and portrait mode is your highest priority and your budget is under ₹15,000, then you can buy the Mi A1. But if taking selfies and recording video is your highest priority and you don't mind spending over ₹20,000, then you can go with the Zenfone 4 Selfie Pro. Nonetheless, both the cameras have their own pros and cons. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you did, then give this video a like, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel for some more tech product videos in the future. That's all for this video. Then thank you guys so much for watching. This has been Amog and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye bye and take care.